Welcome back, everyone. It's been a while since I've made a video. I got really busy with many stuff, so I wanted to pick back up on my series of American military bases in Latin America in the Western Hemisphere. So the next subject of this video will be on the Guantanamo Bay Naval Base in Cuba. It is America's oldest military base in another country, and it was established by the United States in 1903, so that was over 100 years ago now. So in the history of America's bases in Latin America, it really does all begin with Cuba and the Guantanamo Bay Naval Base. So let's get into a lot of the history to present of this infamous naval base. So before the United States ever had access to Cuba, it was a Spanish colony. In fact, Cuba, along with Puerto Rico, were the final two colonies the Spanish had in the Americas, in the Caribbean. Cuba was a longtime colony of Spain, going back to at least the 1500s or 1600s. 1500s, I would say. And they controlled it until the Spanish-American War of 1898, when the United States ended up going to war with the Spanish, especially in Cuba and Puerto Rico, the last two colonies that Spain had in the Caribbean. And the United States defeated the Spanish within a year in the Spanish-American War of 1898, and with it, Spain lost their last two colonies, and Puerto Rico was instantly made a U.S. territory, and I'll go into that in another video. And Cuba kind of got a semi-independence. So the United States, after taking Cuba and Puerto Rico from the Spanish, decided quickly to establish a naval base in Cuba and an American military occupation on the island. The United States ended up creating what was called the Platt Amendment in 1901, which was implemented in Cuba's constitution to grant the United States to lease lands in Cuba to quote-unquote maintain Cuba's independence, which is kind of ironic, since they were basically forfeiting any type of independence by doing that, the Cubans. And a lot of Cubans actually were very resistant to it, but didn't really have a chance against the large United States north of them. From the Spanish-American War until 1922, the United States engaged in several invasions and occupations on the island of Cuba. The United States engaged in interventions and occupations in Cuba from 1898, the Spanish-American War, all the way until 1922. And the United States also used the naval base in Cuba to launch invasions of other Caribbean islands, including Haiti and the Dominican Republic, during what was called the Banana Wars, which was a series of American invasions on Caribbean islands, Mexico, and Central American countries during the early 20th century, which was fought over especially the control of tropical fruit and the supply lines of it in those countries. So the United States treated Cuba as a banana republic and interfered a lot with their politics and used their natural resources, especially like sugar and tobacco. And the country became America's playground as well, where casinos and hotels were all over the place in Cuba and were controlled by the Italian-American mafia as well. That's another story. And the United States supported several dictators in Cuba, most notably Fulgencio Batista, who was the military strongman off and on from the 1930s to the 1950s in Cuba. Things started changing in the 1950s. That's when the Cuban Revolution began, led by Fidel and Raul Castro brothers, leading an armed revolution against the dictator and America's ally, Fulgencio Batista, and they succeeded in forcing him out of power in 1959. So after that, U.S.-Cuban relations turned very hostile, but the United States wanted to keep their naval base there. The Platt Amendment of 1901 essentially gave the United States a permanent lease, almost, to use the naval base in Cuba. And the United States has still to this day not backed down and said they will not leave the base until they choose on their own to do it, which is basically never. The United States severed relations with Cuba in the early 1960s after Fidel Castro took power and engaged in, to this day, a trade embargo on the island of Cuba and severed diplomatic relations with them. The Cubans were able to get a lot of American businesses out of Cuba and close the casinos and hotels, but yes, the naval base stayed and has been a sore point to this day between Cuba and the United States. Several times, the Cuban government has requested that America leave, and as I said, the U.S. says no. After the United States and Cuba ended up severing diplomatic relations with each other, the United States military and the Cuban government established fencing and gates and a wall to separate the naval base from the rest of Cuba, which exists to this day. At one point in the 1960s, the U.S. military and the Cuban government ended up putting landmines at the demilitarized zone, and things have been very tense between the two sides. And I think the most tense, obviously, was during the Cuban Missile Crisis of 1962. I don't have enough time in this video to go in depth about the Cuban Missile Crisis, but it was when the Russians started sending nuclear missiles to Cuba, and it was the closest we ever got to having a nuclear war. And despite all that, the Guantanamo Bay Naval Base stayed. The U.S. stayed at the base to this day. Now I'm going to fast forward to a little more recent incidents in history with the Guantanamo Bay Naval Base, and that includes the detention camp, the infamous detention camp. Since 2002, the United States has used the Guantanamo Bay Naval Base to imprison suspected captured terrorists. After the September 11th attacks in 2001, the United States declared a war on terrorism, and the U.S. invaded countries such as Afghanistan and captured suspected terrorists. And then the U.S. military would bring these captured suspected terrorists all the way to the Guantanamo Bay Naval Base, where they would torture and interrogate them. And this has been a huge controversial thing to this day, a very ugly recent chapter of the U.S. government in the use of torture. And there's been some, how do I say this? Sometimes some of the captured suspects ended up not being terrorists. And there's several people, even to this day, still detained at the Guantanamo Bay Naval Base who are suspected terrorists. And the United States engaged, the U.S. military engaged in interrogation and torture tactics, including waterboarding. And this has been another stain on the history of the Guantanamo Bay Naval Base. And so here we are more than 120 years later, and the United States military still has a naval base in Cuba, even though the Cuban government since the 1960s has demanded that the U.S. leave the base and leave their country. And still to this day, the United States has imprisoned terrorist suspects detained at the naval base as well. And the U.S. still has no plans of ever closing any of its bases or ever leaving Cuba. And this still remains a very weird, tense, awkward standoff between the United States and Cuba going back more than 120 years back in history. And who knows when this will really ever be truly resolved.